Hello, David Akubi and Bearwoods Photography. And I want to take a few minutes just to not do an unboxing video because you obviously see the lens is already out of the box. But I want to do another first impression video of Tamron's new 11-20 f2.8 DI3-A RXD lens. Now, it is their second lens of their newer series that they've made specifically for the APS-C lenses. That's what that dash A means. The first one they made is the 17-70 f2.8. This is the next in that line, which is the 11-20. So what those two give me now is 11 millimeters up to 70, or the equivalent of 16.5 millimeters up to 105 millimeters in f2.8. So let me just talk about a few of the features in this, then I'm going to talk about the bigger picture for a second as well. Everything about the lens, it's extremely light. I've got my cheat sheet here, so you'll see me look down. Everything about the lens is just really great. Again, 11-20, f2.8 all the way through the range. It is a whopping 3.4 inches when it is all the way in. Goes out about another half inch or so. So you're looking at, that's still under 4 inches, I would say, or right at 4 inches, extended out all the way. The weight of it is 11.8 ounces, which is great. And we're going to talk about that with some other stuff over here in a second. Fluorine coating on the front of the lens, which is really nice. It just simply, if you get something on the front of the lens, it wipes off much, much easier. It's got the BBAR2 coating on it. So if you're shooting into light, it reduces or eliminates the lens flare. Like all their newer stuff, it is also weather sealed. So you can photograph and not really be concerned about the weather as much. Minimum focusing distance. When I'm using an ultra wide angle lens like this, I love to have that front element very, very close to something to, you know, make that element in the foreground look really big, like a flower or a log or something. And then have the secondary object, my subject, back in the background. And it can be fairly far off. So some of them, when you look at some of the pictures I've got at the end of this video, I didn't do any focus stacking. So, I want to see how well it did. If I need to focus stack, I would. But just for the video's sake, I went ahead and I did not do that. Depth of field is depth of field. Nothing you can change. That's the characteristics, the physics of the lenses. So minimum object distance. At the wide side, it is minimum object difference. It is 5.9 inches from this point. So you're looking at about that far. And it'll be in focus at 11 millimeters. At 20 millimeters, it jumps out to 9.4. What that does is that at the close range, it gives you a 1:4 macro. So your subject is going to be 4 times the size of the sensor. At the telephoto side, it's 1:7.6. So that's still fairly close that you're able to focus. And that's really going to give you some neat ultra wide angle effects. So I think, you know, everything with it, it's got the lens hood, got the fluorine coating, got the rear seal, beautiful, lightweight lens, compact. So I want to push some stuff aside for a second and just talk about another reason that I like it. Now, I discussed the aspect of 11-20 f2.8. It's made to work in combination with your 17-70 f2.8. You can see very, very compact as well. I'm trying to be able to make sure we can see these. So these two lenses give me 16.5 millimeter to 105 millimeters f2.8. Those by themselves, it's a great combination to do portraits, to go out and do events. Great landscape combination, very lightweight. The two lenses together weigh a total of about 30 ounces. So you're looking still at very, very lightweight, very compact, easy to carry. The little bag that I've been carrying them around in when I'm doing some of the shooting the past week that I've been shooting is a 25 liter bag. The actual compartment of it is probably about 15 liters. Fits everything in there great, extra batteries. And it also carries another lens for me. And I think it's important just to throw this out there and show it as well, because it could be a perfect combination for the photographer that wants to do everything from wide angle photography to fairly medium telephoto. It's the 70-200 f4.5 to 6.3 RXD lens. So again, made for the Sony full frame, but it works great on this. It becomes the equivalent of 105 millimeters to 450 millimeters. So right here in front of me, this tiny little package, I've got 11 to 300, which is the equivalent of 16.5 millimeters to 450 millimeters. With the addition of this, you're still looking at just over 3 pounds for all of that. Then the body itself, half pound, pound maybe at most. I think it's just a great combination. I plan on using it a lot, especially when I'm traveling. I'm going to Iceland in a couple months. I'll have these three lenses in this body, as well as a full frame with the 17-28 and the 28-200. Then I'm covering everything I could possibly need to cover, whether it be full frame or APS-C. So, super system. This lens just really tops it off for me, because with these, the combination, you're wanting that ultra wide in there to do some of the things that you're looking to do. That lens answers that question for you. Absolutely perfect. Again, fits into a tiny little bag. I can carry a smaller tripod because there's not a lot of weight in these. Just everything about it has really given me everything that I'm looking for. So I'm going to put some images at this point in the video from Gibbs Garden that I shot at last week. And then this morning I went to one of the local waterfalls over in Dahlonega, Georgia. It's called Dix Creek Falls. And there's some logs in the foreground that I really like to use for that ultra wide angle photography. So I'll have those at the end of the video. Take a look at it, see what you think. Any questions, shoot them to me down below. Other than that, have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon. So I hope you enjoyed the images, and hopefully if you're looking to get into lighter, more compact, but maintain that sharpness, this is a kit that you'll consider. It's a great ultra-wide lens. I hope to get out in a couple weeks and do some nightscapes with it and see how it works as well. If I do, I'll post some images and do a little video or something. But anyway, if you like the content of the video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you don't subscribe to my channel, go ahead and do that as well. Otherwise, get out, have some fun. Everything's opened up and running around. So we'll talk to you later. Bye.